The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by EduPal, home of the $5 courses. Check out my Excel class, Excel Formulas of the Dirty Dozen, at tinyurl.com/EduPal5. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1921, Draw a Line with Excel Power Map. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question is about Excel Power Map. How do we draw a line in Power Map? Now, that's not built into Excel, but it is possible to simulate drawing a line. So here we have a simple data set with just two data points. This data point over here on the right-hand side is in Florida, and it's actually the Cocoa Beach Pier. The data point over here on the left-hand side, that's out in California, and that's the Santa Monica Pier. So today we want to do a little pier-to-pier work and draw a line that illustrates the connection between those two points. All right, so we're back in Excel. Here is my big database of the two points, longitude, latitude. There's the height category. I'm going to use that category to make the line a different color than the beginning and end point and dates. I currently have these just arbitrary dates in here. The delta between the latitude and longitude, B3 minus B2, C3 minus C2. How many points do we want? Well, to make a nice smooth line, I'm going to use 3,000 points. That's about 1 point every mile. And so that calculates the delta per point. All right, so let's copy and paste that data as values. And then I'm going to insert 3,000 rows. So F5, let's select A3 colon A3002. And then Alt-IR to insert some rows. All right, so here's what we're going to do. Point 1, the longitude is going to be the value just above me, plus the delta. Press F4 there two times to lock it down to just row 2, and then copy that across. The height here is always going to be 5, the category is going to be B, and then for the dates, I want to take the date above me and add 1. That way, as we animate this, it should go right across. Let's get rid of all of these dates here, and see what happens when we copy this down. All right, really nice that the point 1 extended to point 2, point 3, point 4. Those formulas are working. Because I put equal 5 there, that does not extend. Category B, they don't know how to fill B to C to D, so that all works. And the dates look good down here at the bottom. Perfectly, yeah. So I knew I was going to use 3,000 points. That's why we end there on 1126. And the height goes back up. All right, so we're going to go back to Power Map and refresh. And I'll get rid of the tour editor, bring back the layer pane. And we're going to say that the color is the category. And then the date field is the time. All right. And we're going to get rid of this area. And we should be able to come back here to the original data point, which gets us just the Cocoa Beach Pier. And then when I play the tour, line animates going across, and finally the Santa Monica Pier. So there you go. Does Power Map do lines? Well, no, not built in, but using a little bit of interpolation, you can create your own line. All right, there you have it. Well, hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.com.